That's good. 448 pace. Come on, come on. Don't settle. All gas, no gaps. All gas, no gaps. Come on. 150 mile week, and this is the end of a massive, massive training block. Body. There you go. 452.
陸上選手、マラソンランナーとしてのゴールを8月8日に決めました。
Okay, 10 minutes of running. Tokyo is going to be 10 times as hard. So you better just get tough right now.You're the toughest runner in the world, but you gotta practice it right now.
Yeah, what a journey. I've never had the privilege to coach an athlete who's actually made so many lifestyle sacrifices. Didn't know the language at all. Brought over an infant child, him and his wife. Just really just went, dived all in.
それは東京を自分自身の競技人生の最高のゴールにするためです。2013年大会が決まってから東京を目標にしてきました。最高の舞台にするために自分の 100% を注ぎ込んできました。次があるっていう言い訳を強制的になくしたくてこの大会をゴールにしました。このレースで終わりなんだって決めた今、自分の持てる全ての力が出し切れる気がしています。東京ゴールに決めて、これが自分の最後のマラソンになるんだって考えて、ふと今の瞬間に改めて立ち返ってみると、風の匂いだったり雨の音、練習中の筋肉の張りだったり、着地した時の感覚だったりとか、すごく繊細に感じて、そしてすごく大切に思えて、ゴールまでそういうものを大切にして走り切りたいって思いました。
It's been a really special last 6 years as a coach, 7 years. And to see it come to this point where he's going into the Olympic Games and theBattle that it took just to make it on that, probably one of the hardest teams in the world to make for the marathon, and just his persistence sort of created his own empire, and has goals of changing the future of Japanese running and giving opportunities to youngsters and young women, whether that's through coaching or through opportunities even in America and even creating opportunities in Japan.It's something really special to see, and as much as he's done in the marathon, breaking national records, helping establish Japan as a world power in the marathon again, international races like Chicago and Boston and so forth, and Tokyo. What he's done there, I think he's going to do greater things when he's done with actually competitive running.